Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at using relative and absolute cell references in formulas in Numbers. So I'm using Numbers version 3 here. And let's take a look at the difference between relative and absolute cell references in formulas. So let's populate this table with some sample data. And let's just put some random numbers in here. And let's go ahead and then perform some calculations based on this. So let's just add this to this and subtract this. There we go. And the great thing is that we could then copy and paste this formula, something different, from here to here, and it will perform the calculation on a different row. So in this case, you can see it's showing me right here, it's using these three cells to get that number. And if I double click on it, I can see it's B2 plus C2 minus D2. Great. Here it's using these three cells. I copied and pasted, and the cell references changed to reflect the change in position. I went from E2 to E3. I increased the row by one, so it increased the row by one for each one of these. So now instead of B2, it's B3. Instead of C2, it's C3. And instead of D2, it's D3. And I get a new formula. And I can continue doing this as much as I want, and it will continue to change. So in this case, you can see it's using these, and there we go. It's all from row 4 now instead of row 3. These are relative cell references. As I move the formula down one row, it's going to move all of the references down one row as well. Now let's add a little wrinkle to this. Let's go and add a new row here. I'm going to erase this formula. I'm going to erase all the formulas here. We're going to use a new formula. And in this row, we're going to actually put another number. And we're going to put number 2. And the formula now is going to be this plus this plus this times what's in here. So B3 plus C3 plus D3 times G2. And the answer is going to be 86. Which would make sense. But here's what happens if I copy this formula and I paste it. Now notice it has moved all references down one because they're all relative. Up here it's these three and this one. Down here it's these three and this one, which is not what we want. We want it to stay here. We want it to always use this number 2. So we need to switch the reference for this cell from a relative one that would change to an absolute one that will not change. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's delete the formula here. There we go. Delete it. Go to this formula here and we'll edit it. And we want these remain relative and this one to be absolute. You notice that there's a little menu arrow there. We can select that and we could select preserve row and or preserve column. We're not moving things around in columns, so we don't really care about columns here. But we'll just set both of them to be absolute. So in other words, no matter where this formula gets copied and pasted, this cell is going to remain exactly at G2. And it puts dollar signs in front of both the column and the row to let us know that these are now absolute. And this is pretty standard spreadsheet stuff going back decades using the dollar sign there. So the result is going to be the same here. But if I copy and paste, you see how it's using these three, but it's still using this one. And if I look in here, I can see there's a dollar sign. It's dollar sign G, dollar sign 2. And no matter where I paste this, it's going to continue to use this absolute cell, even though it's using these relative cells. So the same concept applies whether the cell is in this table or another sheet. You want to make sure that if you always want it to be absolute, to be preserved, to be this exact cell, G2, you want to turn that on in the formula right there. And then for these, you want them to move around with it. You want to make sure that that's turned off. And that's how you use relative cell references and absolute cell references in your formulas.